Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today in this video we are going to print this pattern. This is alphabet 2. So before we are going to print this pattern, we are convert this pattern to the before we if we are going to print this pattern will be divided into rows and columns like this. Okay, so if you print this pattern, we are converted rows and columns. So let us take some names about these patterns. So I will take I for rows, J for columns. Okay, so let us take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, this one 1, 2, 3. Sorry, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Okay, if you observe this one, we can easily understand where the star values will be printed. Okay, so this is I value, this is row, this is J value, this is column. Okay, now whenever I value equal to 1, so before we are going to logically, I will tell one thing. So if you observe this pattern, we never ever use this pattern. We cannot print this pattern like this. So this is not good to way to print this pattern. Okay, so that's why we are going to print this pattern using dynamically. That means if you give the value based on that value, the pattern will be printed. If you observe here, whenever I value equal to 1, so at that time the star will be printed. Right, so up to when if J equal to 4, right? J equal to 4. Okay, let us take some example. I will take here, I will take 5 into 5, 5 rows and 5 columns, right? So that's why taking some n value equal to 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, whenever I value equal to 1 and J value equal to up to 4, that means J value 1 equal to 1 time, it will print star, 1 equal to 2 star, 1, 3 star, 1, 4 star. Okay, in last step, we have to print, skip this, print the sum space. Okay, so how we can print the, if you see this one, the final value is 5. Okay, whenever n equal to 5 minus J equal to 5 minus 1. Okay, J equal to 5 minus 1. That means J value equal to 4. Up to 4, the stars will be printed. Okay, next part. Next, the cursor will be moved to this part. So here I am using two for loops. One is outer for loop, one is nested for loop. Okay, so whenever I value equal to 2, so it will print only 2-1 position and 2-5 position. So we know we know how to print this one. So it will take 2-1 2-2, this row is 2-3 2-4 2-5. Okay, it will print 2-1 position. It will print 2-1 position star, 2-5 position 1. Remaining all will be spaces. Okay. Like that, whatever you written in the condition here, the same condition will be using here. Here we are using I equal to n by 2. Okay. Here we are using I equal to n by 2 plus 1. For example, n equal to 5 na, 5 by 2. Plus 1 means we are taking all values in integer, na? So it will take 2. actually we are getting 2.5, but here we are using variable integer, so it will not take it will take only digit 2. So 2 plus 1 we will get 3. 2 plus 1 you will get 3. So whenever I value equal to 3, so you can use same logic here. This one j equal to 4, the same logic we are using here. So after that it will print some space, and the same logic we are going to use this one, and finally we are going to use the this part to print the our pattern. Okay, so I will tell after again also how to analyze the program. Before we are going to program, we know here I am using and or. We know what is the difference and or. Okay, we will understand this and or operators in the Java. Okay, in normally this is truth tables, and this both are truth tables. Okay, so a and b, if a is true, b is true, it will be true. This is and, this is or. If a is true, b is false, it is false. If anyone is false. Here also, if anyone is false. So here two are false. So this means this also false. So this is AND operator. OR operator means opposite to this one. That means if anyone is true, it is true. So here it is true, it is false. But anyone is true, it is true. Right? It is true. Here also true. But if anyone is false, it will print false value. Okay, here we are using under or both operators. And where we can use in if operator, if condition, if else condition. Okay, if else condition, we can use if else condition. So by using if else condition, we can use this both operator functionalities. Operator functionality. Okay, next we are going to directly coding part. After coding part I will explain how we can write that program. So this is my program. So if you observe here, I have printed that pattern. So if you observe here, I didn't write I didn't write my program like this. So if you see my program, I didn't write like this. I written my program dynamically. If you give enter any value, wait. Enter any value. If I give 5, it will print 5. So if I print 10, it will print B. Okay. Now coming to the coding here, I am taken two for loops. One is nested outer for loop. Another one is nested for loop. So outer for loop is I can take as I. So in nested for loop I can take as j. So I means outer for loop, that means rows. J means columns. So if you observe here, j column every time incremented by 1, 2, 3, 4, but I will only incremented by one time, but it will never back to the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So but j value every time it will be incremented. So that's why I am taking j value into the nested for loop. Okay, nested for loop. That means if condition is true, again it will start it to the j equal to 1. Okay, coming to the nested for loop and j for loop. Okay, wait, I will take one more here. Let's see. Now for I equal to 1 and I less than or equal to n, let us take n equal to 5. Okay, this is outer for loop. Now our value how much? 1. I equal to 1 now. Okay, for j equal to 1, j less than or equal to n, now j value 1, j less than or equal to n, that means 1 less than or equal to 5. Okay, so condition is true. Okay, wait, I will write, I will draw here rows and columns table. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, this is I. This is J. Okay, so now J equal to 1. So the cursor is here. So condition is true. 1 less than or equal to 5. Condition is true. If condition is true, it will go to the inside border, right? Here I am written using and or. That means we know Bodmer's rule. So first, if I write like this one, first do the bracket inside the braces. Whatever operation you do, first do this two operations. Then after add. So like that. Here also we are doing by using this rule. Here also it will be for perform. Okay. So here I am using and or operator. Now check the condition. J double equal to n. J value how much? 1. 1 double equal to 5. No. 1 double equal to 5. So if this one is false, right? And so if any one is false, if in and operator, if any one first one is false, the cursor not move to the next condition. The compiler not checking to the next condition. So it will go to the another condition. Okay, in this basis, the compiler, if first one is false, the compiler never ever check this once. Why? Because this is and operator. And operator means if any one is false, totally false. Anyone is false, totally false. Right. This is and operator operation. So after that I double equal to 1. So I value how much? 1 double equal to 1. True. J less than or equal to n minus 1. So J value how much? 1. 1 less than or equal to n minus 1. That means 4. So condition true. Both conditions are true. In operators, both conditions are true. That means what? True. Right. So here one more is the or operator. So here, based on or operator, if any one value is true, the compiler never ever check this remaining condition. Directly it will print star which position? Here. In this position star will be printed. After that and it will be printed. After that again J value incremented by, it will go to the increment part and J value incremented by 2. We are in nested for loop. So the compiler will go to this part in this position. Okay, same J double equal to n. 2 double equal to n means 5. False. So again it will be false. So if it is false, compiler never ever check this condition. So again I double equal to 1, condition is true. J less than or equal to n minus 1. That means 2 less than or equal to 4. 2 less than or equal to 4. Condition true. Both conditions true. So it will print star. It will print star in this position. Okay. Again, J value incremented by 1. So that means now J value 3. Okay. If again we can check the condition j less than or equal to j value 3, we can check the condition 3 less than or equal to 5. Condition true. If condition is true, it will go to this part and j double equal to n. No, 3 double equal to 5. No, so that means false. So it is false. So if it is false, it is never ever check this condition. So it will go to the direct this part. Now I double equal to 1. So till now I value 1. So condition is true. Now j less than or equal to n minus 1. J value almost 3. So 3 less than or equal to 5. Condition true. So if condition true, it will print the star. If both conditions true in R operator, we cannot check this remaining conditions, right? So it will print directly in this position. Okay, next j value incremented by 4. Now j value how much? 4. So again j less than or equal to 4 less than or equal to 5. Condition true. If condition is true, it will go to the if body j double equal to n false. So this is also j value how much? 4. 4 double equal to n value how much? 5. False. Right. False. So if it is false, it will go to the next to check the condition I double equal to 1. So if I double equal to 1, right, condition is true. I double equal to 1, condition is true. And j less than or equal to n minus 1. J value how much? 4. 4 less than or equal to 4. Condition true. Condition true. If condition is true, it will print star in this position. Okay. In this position. So now we are going to again check this condition. Right. So again, after printing, again j value increment, it will go to here, j value incremented by 5. J value incremented by 5. That means here 5 less than or equal to 5. 5 less than or equal to 5. Condition true. So now observe here, based on our pattern, here we cannot print any star. It will print empty space. Now let us check if it is working or not. So j double equal to n. J double equal to n. J value how much? Now 5. Right. 5 double equal to n means 5. Condition true. Condition true. So I not equal to 1. 1 not equal to 1. It is this condition is false. Why? Because false. 1 equal to 1. 1 equal to 1. So this is true. So here we are telling 1 not equal to 1. But 1 equal to 1. So this is false. So this one is false. If it is false, compiler never ever check this remaining condition. Directly it will go to another condition here. Now I value 1 true. I value how much? 1. 1 double equal to 1. Condition true. It will print true. J less than or equal to n minus 1. So here what will we have? 5 less than or equal to 4. N minus 1 means 4. No? N value 5. So it will add 5 minus 1, that is 4. So condition is false. This one also false. This one also false. But here we are using AND operator. In AND operator, both the conditions are true. If both the condition is true, based on that value, it will be printed. Right. Okay, coming to next part. Again, it will go to the next condition. I double equal to n by 2 plus 1. J less than or equal to n minus 1. I value how much? 1. 1 double equal to n by 2 plus 1. N value how much? 5 by 2 plus 1. We will get 3. Okay. will get 2.5, but we are using integer, never ever take the after the point decimal value. The compiler never take decimal value, so it will take 2, 2 plus 1, 3. So 1 double equal to 3, false. So 1 double equal to 3, false. This one also false. If it is false, in AND operator, this is false. If AND operator, we never ever check this condition. Why? Because it is false. If anyone is false, it is false in AND operator. So if it is next compiler going to this condition, check this condition, I double equal to n. So I value how much? 1. 1 double equal to 5. Condition false. So here also condition is false. If condition is false, the compiler never ever check this condition. So it also will be false. So observe, this one is false, this one is false, all the conditions is false. This one are false, this one is false, false, false. Okay, now check the final condition, j double equal to 1. So now j value how much? 5, right? 5. 5 double equal to 1, condition false. So this one also false. So in our operator, all conditions is false. Okay, let us see this one. Okay, this is our operator, no? So final operator, all operators will be false. If all condition is false, we will get final result is false. Okay, same like that. Here we are getting all false. So based on the if condition is true, it will print this one. If condition is false, it will go to the else part. So else part, what we have given space, so the space will be printed here. So like that, this pattern will be work same. This position, star position, right, this position, so and this position, this position. That means this is the first of the table and this is the last column of the row, last row. This is the last row of the table. This one is the middle row of the table, right? So after that, so if you have any doubt, write in comment section, I will tell. That's no problem. Okay, if you have any doubt, write in comment section. Okay, now okay, now we are going to second row. So after the completion, it will go again, it will be j value incremented by 5 now. It will go to the 6 less than or equal to, now check the condition, this condition, 6 less than or equal to 5. Condition is false. If condition is false, it will come out for this loop and it will go to the this for loop. Here we have again I value incremented by 2. So now I value incremented by 2. Here we can check the condition, 2 less than or equal to 5. So condition true. If condition is true, it will go to the inside the for loop body. Based on this condition, it will print here 1 star and here 1 star, and remaining will be spaces. Okay, remaining will be spaces. So I was explaining everything. So if you have trace for yourself, so if you have any doubt, write in comment section. Definitely I will reach you and I will tell you. So remaining this one also trace you. So this is our code to print the pattern in generalization method. This is called generalization method. So every company is asking to print any pattern in generalization method, not only one or based on not single digit number. If the client will be enter any value, if I am enter any value, based on that value it will print br everything. Okay, this is the generalization method. So we are writing only in this form and every program. Okay, thank you everyone. If you have any doubt, write in comment section. I will reach you and I will clarify your doubt. Okay, if you want to really learn programming language, please click subscribe button and press the, if you have really liked my coding skill, my explanation, press the like button. And if in future anything I uploaded related to programming, if you wanna see that programming, press the bell icon. If you press the bell icon, it will reach my programming in futures, whatever I uploaded. So thank you everyone.